First, we clearly have a humanitarian crisis as a result of that. It was mentioned already, wheat prices, wheat supply, all that other stuff, which will impact, in particular, some of the developing countries. But we also have to look at solutions in the long run. So we need to find a solution, short-term humanitarian crisis. One suggestion was made that some of the developed countries would release some of their food storage. I think that might be a good idea. But then we have to look long-term in what is it that we do. And for me, it continues to be that we have to grow the crops where they get the highest output. And at the same time, we have to support the 500 million smallholder farmers around the world in order for them to make a decent living and also to produce the crop for their communities. And I think this can be achieved. And I think innovation will continue to play a major role in that. And that's where also BASF, but many other companies come into play. I'll give you two examples. We have last year, we introduced in India a chatbot where farmers free of charge can basically identify diseases and weed problems and find some solutions for it. Or in Egypt, we also introduced free of charge, if you are signed up to it, a pre-warning satellite type of system where farmers get an early warning if certain diseases are approaching. So there are many things that can be done, but I come back to it cannot be done by one individual, it cannot be done by one company alone, it has to be done together.
Oh, I agree 100% as an innovation company, it's just as BASF. I mean, our contribution can only be to bring new solutions to the markets, whether it's new active ingredients, whether it's biologicals that supplement these active ingredients, whether it's new traits, new type of seed varieties, where we work a lot on hybridization, for example, of wheat, which would be a game changer also in the industry, and where we would see increased yield similar to what we had seen in the past in corn and in soybean. We work a lot on digital type of solutions, and we are launching also here at this event. We are also launching a new platform, which is called AgroStart, which we launched first in Latin America, which is basically an open innovation type of platform, primarily to early or late type of startup companies, in order to get in touch with certain experts to develop solutions. I mean, not just for the developed countries, but also beyond.
Well, I think I couldn't agree with you more. And I think at least from a technology company, we try to do that. We try to include them also in things that we innovate. And I mentioned a couple of examples to you, which was the chatbot in India, or also this early detection system in Egypt. And I agree with you, we probably have to bring it a little bit more onto the map. But I keep on saying, and I think we should be cognizant of that, that crops should be grown where at the end, at least the large crops system, they should be grown where we have the highest output. I mean, if we try to revert that, I don't think we are going to be able to feed the growing population on less arable land.
I always have hope. I think for me, the glass is always half full, even though right now it's half empty. And I think that in the long run, we have always prevailed through innovation and also being able to get together, come together as a society through partnerships, and we will solve some of these problems. The question is only when.
BASF, we create chemistry.